Thanks everyone for coming out. This is really nice. And we'll probably be thanking all the bands that came and played tonight because they're all friends and they all mean a lot to us. So we're gonna have a lot of these breaks. You see these breaks we're doing? There's gonna be a lot of these little breaks. So we'll be talking.
Anyone who ever complained about a set that was too short is going to be like, you're not going to ever want to see us play again after today. It's good timing.
I already hate it.
Seriously, thank you guys for all being here. This is definitely the most people that's ever been to a Comadre show in the Bay Area, like, by far. So thank you. Are you ready? All right, we're going to do three more. This is some old shit. This is for Susie from Reno.
I would rather take a mile out here to our stream than pray on the incentive in blame. I would rather take a mile out here.
You guys doing okay? Hey, once again, thanks for everyone coming out from far places. I know some of you had to travel some distances to get here. So, thanks for doing that. That's really swell.
I got a story, maybe. Is that alright if we tell a story? Alright, so... Oh yeah, we're not gonna tell... I have no jokes. But, so... Neil's got jokes. We'll talk about Neil in a minute. But first, well, I wanted to talk about Broadway Calls. I know, huh? Okay, just chronologically it makes sense. It's like all three of those dudes that are in that band, Ty and Josh and Adam, just being a hardcore band called Countdown to Life.
Yeah!
Cool. And so when we met those dudes, they were in that band. And, you know, one of our first experiences traveling out of the Bay Area, we found ourselves up in their neck of the woods in the northeast. Northwest, that's what I meant to say. And they were like some of the first band dudes we met that weren't from here, and they were the nicest, most hospitable people that we come across in a really long time. And like, we always know that we have a place to stay, whether they're there or not. Ty's mom, Mary Vaughn, is the nicest lady ever. Ty's mom. One of our tours was around Thanksgiving in 2005, and they were going to be gone too, and she made us all a Thanksgiving dinner. And even though those dudes are from the Northwest, where they like to like hunt and shit, and they like eat animals and stuff, Mary Vaughn made a special 5 servings worth of vegan Thanksgiving dinner for us, which was like the sweetest thing ever. Also, last story, one time, they had us up there for a Halloween show, and
maybe the same trip,
I don't know. But we played with them, and we wore only grass skirts and coconut bras.
They wore Winnie the Pooh costumes.
And some like really tough Northwest, you know, remember they hunt and eat animals and shit. like, got real tough with me, because I was, like, rubbing my ass up against him when my grass foot came off. He didn't appreciate it, not too much. Anyways, we've had a lot of fun experience with those dudes. They're very close friends. That's why they came down and played. We have stories about all the bands, but that's good for now. I think we'll get to the rest later. Oh, that's a different band. So here's more. Thanks, you guys.
Now we're both broken.
You have a Justin story?
Yeah, you got to talk about T-Show.
Who's got a Justin story?
I got Justin
story. We got plenty of Justin stories.
That's okay?
No, that's all right. I'm just going to skip that part. Hey, I want to give a huge, huge, huge thank you to Max. Anything cool that we've done in the Bay Area, that guy has been, been a part of it. So thank you, guys. Thank you, Max, so much for coming on the show and taking our shit. I didn't want to raise a little thanks to anyone that drove out a while to be here. I know there's a bunch of people from LA, SoCal, in general. People from out of state, Reno, of course. Yeah. North Carolina now. Oh, that's right. Mexico, Germany, or down Africa. Down Africa, the man, the myth. Legend. Thank you, Bass Jesus. Here's an old one. This one goes after Redwood City.
Why I'm there, the man who's
The guy in the back, that's Chucho right there. If you've seen a band from Southern California in the last 8 years, it was one of his bands. The very last day of our very first U.S. tour, we met a band called Graf Orlok. We didn't go to sleep together on the same floor, but we somehow woke up together on the same floor, and hung out all day and swam in the Truckee. And these guys are like a bunch of grindcore dudes. They're like, this band's gonna fucking suck later when we play this band. And I remember them all looking at each other like, oh, it's all right, I guess. Even though the hand claps and all that stuff. And then 4 tours later, there was a divorce and like all kinds of weird, bad blood. But it's cool because we're like best friends, and we put out this last record, and we thank him for that because he's a sweet, sweet fucking man. And Ghostwind, and Dangers, and Graf Orlok. Death Room number 9. Fires of Voice. Oh, Vitriol Records, the whole thing. Yeah. He also wrote a book. Buy that book. Who reads? And you're like, you're reading those Ghostland lyrics, like, oh, this shit's pretty smart. I don't know, like, this is not like that Graf Orlok band that other guy's in. And it turns out he's like a history professor.
Shut up.
Who knew? I said, I can't believe that we made it this far into the set already without passing out. Do you want to talk about the last thing? Well, so we're it's not dramatic. That was way too dramatic for us.
This is
it, yeah. Now we got 5 more songs to go.
We have to talk a bunch because we never play this song, and it's really hard. But I did want to add that, we didn't really say anything about why we're not going to be a band anymore. And the only thing that matters is that we've said many, many times that if anyone left this band, we wouldn't replace them. Because I hate when I get to know a band and then I go see them and it's a bunch of different people. And I'm like, well, this isn't the same fucking band. This isn't the band I fell in love with. Like, this is not the same thing. And so, when we started this band, some of us were still in fucking high school. And now this band is over, and like, everyone who wanted to go to college is done with that, kind of. Or going back again, because it was so much fun the first time. And we're getting married, some of us, and shit. And some of us have already been married for almost 4 years. This is my wife, Vanessa. And I'm not saying, I'm definitely not saying that any of us are growing up and out of punk, because that's not true. But it's just hard to do a full-time band when you've got all this other real-life shit piling up. At some point, if we keep doing this, what? You equate it to real life is not flattering? Oh, right. Whatever. You know that I love you a lot. And that's all I'm saying. I'm like, if we keep doing this, I don't want to be one of those bands that like fizzles out and you're like, hey, what the fucking happened to those guys? Are they still playing? It's still a band? Like, someone check punk news. Is there a thing? Like, So whatever, that's all I'm saying, like the time came, one person can't do it, it doesn't matter, and so we're done, that's it. We're the 5 guys that started this band, we're the 5 guys that are ending this band on our turn. thank you, and there's no bad blood, we're all still buds. We just put out the record that we are the most proud of, and if you don't like it, that's fine. Realistically, we probably won't do anything better than that. So just, if you haven't heard it, check it out. We're not even gonna try it at this point. And that's not, whatever. Thanks again for being here. Yeah.
thanks again. So I don't really talk much when we play, and I'm gonna keep it that way. So we have a couple more songs after this. But yeah.
Hey. So, we picked these last three songs because these are the last three songs that we ever want to play together. So, and I want to thank you guys so much for being here. There's so many good friends here. It's fucking crazy. I barely had time to say hi to everybody. So, but thank you all for being here. Seriously, all the people, all the bands that drove from out of town, all that shit. All the people that are here that are getting recorded with me, that's fucking so awesome to you guys. Thank you so much. I love being with you guys. Punk Rock Joel is here. Joel's fucking awesome. Punk Rock Joel is taking pictures of like our first shows. Phil Benson's here, by the way. You reminded me today that Phil Benson threw the first handful of confetti in our very first show ever at the PCC. In 04, first real fan. We even Sweden ripped off one of his riffs for one of our first songs. We took that whole fucking thing. Anyway, I don't have anything important. I don't have anything good to say. You guys ready? Three more.
Just that.
Thanks.